Hey everybody, this is Harshith and welcome back to the channel. And in this video, as you can see, I'm completely dressed up like an autistic geek, and that's how I feel today when I'm coding. All right, so now let's get into one of my best AI platforms right now, which is called v0.dev by Vercel. These guys have been shipping fast every single day. The best thing about them is they have integrations and they already have an ecosystem they've built through Vercel, and they're completely integrating that with v0 itself. A lot of features that I want to talk about. So one of them is the chat feature. As you can see, there's a new Figma icon here. You can actually sign in and connect with Figma. And now there's a starter template as well. There are a lot of templates that you can get. Right now there's a feature to request templates as well. And now there are app templates where there'll be a lot of Apple apps where you can just simply clone, right? You can just simply clone these. You can just build your own thing. That's super cool. And the chat library has got some layout changes. And now, as you can see, these are everything that I've been building, like blocks, like student dashboards, affiliate dashboards. These are everything that I've been building previously. So that also you can see. And these are all my previous chats. And there's a folder section, a project section. So now let's just go back to the chat. So you can see the project section. We can actually create projects as well, new project. Right, so this is basically what we'll be learning in this video and the next couple of videos as well. So the first thing we're going to get started with is the app templates. So what exactly are these app templates and how can you use them? So currently we only have 1, 2, and 3. The first one is OpenAI SDK chatbot, and there's a Stripe products and checkout and documentation starter. So imagine this as a Shopify, right? Like if you look at this, Shopify was previously built because non-coders wanted access to creating e-commerce stores when they weren't able to code. But again, Shopify is great, but there's still some amount of customizability that it's not possible to, you know, fully customize the way you want it to, or maybe even you just want to own the source code and, you know, you just want to have it exactly on your name, completely branded. It could be anything, right? I haven't really used Shopify a lot. You know, it was just in the early days, but this is something that you could do. And this is a simple Next.js starter, which was by Vercel itself. And now you can simply just view template and just start editing. All right, so these are the three things that we're gonna do. So you know what, why don't we just get started with the easiest one, which is documentation starter. All right, the moment that you click on it, I mean, look at this. The moment that you click on this, you get this pop-up, which is documentation starter, a Next.js documentation template. All right, so this is actually a template. So now I can either create a new project or select an existing project, right? These were all gibberish. These weren't like real projects that, you know, I was just like, just trying out. So I'm just gonna say, test one YouTube video, all right? And I'm just gonna open my template. So the moment we open the template, it's gonna open the V0 interface, which is basically preview code console. Console is basically when it just shows the terminal, right? All right, perfect, code, right. There are some amazing changes that have happened in the past couple of weeks. As you can see, this is file structure. This wasn't there before. Like, you know, when you were actually trying to do coding, you only got just pieces of code, snippets of code, and that too, it was like in the chat. Maybe, you know what, maybe if I just check like some of my really old chats, maybe I'd have how, yes, this is how it looked like. This was bad. I mean, this was really bad because when I gave this, you know, I gave such a big, you know, prompt, and this was the code, that's it. And this was it. Like, look at it. It was so bad. And yes, you just had to click on this snippet. The snippet then opens the preview. And then you can just click on this for code. This interface was really bad because when you're building actual products, it's not just one code, right? You need the entire code base. And for that, it has to be in a proper folder structure, a folder tree. If it's not in a folder tree, you'll actually have to go back again to Cursor and then start coding on Cursor AI, right? So instead, this is what they did. this is basically, okay, this is great. I can actually make a couple more changes here, I see. Okay, but before that, let's just go ahead. Let's go back to the chat, which we were in. Yes, this was the chat again. It's preview, code, and console. All right, so in code, this is the major changes they made. The folder tree, the files, again, the folder tree. You can clearly see the proper folder tree here, right? It's Next.js, latest version, whatever folder tree that they're creating right now. All right, so now let's look at the preview. Search for docs, this is basically a Notion clone. A Notion clone, and again, this is again ShadCN UI sidebar. Guys, you must be knowing ShadCN UI at this point. If you don't, it's basically, all right, so monorepo, I had no idea this existed. All right, so you know what, next video on this coming out, monorepo. That's perfect. This is crazy. Monorepo is going to change everything. Guys, this, I was doing one video on this, and I see that they've just shipped another feature, which is monorepo. But I will be doing another feature of this. But yes, ShadCN UI, ShadCN UI is a UI library by ShadCN. I think it works with Vercel, and now they've just integrated everything in this ecosystem. All right, so now let's go ahead. This introduction, let's get started. Okay, components, API reference. So, you know what? Let's just try to build something else. Let's say integration with Slack, right? So maybe you're trying to build your own documentation, right? You're trying to build your own documentation, and you also have another page for integration for Slack, right? So let's go ahead and create this integration for Slack. But before that, I'm just going to, for prompts, I'm using Perplexity these days, right? So Perplexity is great for prompts. So here's what I'm going to do. I'm just going to say, I'm working on docs, which is basically my own simple documentation side of my actual code base, back end, and how others could use my product. I would like to add a document about Slack integration. Can you give me a proper prompt on how to do this so that I can simply use this in v0.dev? Okay. All right. And my product is a meme coin trading bot. All right. Let's say, for example, I'm just building a meme coin trading bot. And for that bot, these are the documentation. All right. These are the documentation. This is API, getting started, introduction, components, API reference. All right, so now we just want to add Slack integration. Like Slack, maybe you're getting alerts on Slack, right? All that can happen. All right. So to create a documentation, Slack integration prompt overview. Okay, list any prerequisites needed, the integration such as a Slack integration. All right, set up Slack, build API. Okay. Okay, this looks good. Maybe I'll just ask you to add more. I would like you to add another page in the navigation section. So I'm just specifying this like navigation section just because you don't have a clear idea of what I'm talking about. Navigation section in the left side bar. About what was it again? Slack integration. All right, let me just do this so I understand exactly what I'm saying. And now this is it. Also, v0. Please feel free to expand on it to add it to the documentation. All right, so imagine how easy it is. I don't remember, but there was this one application I was using before to create docs. I forgot, all right. So you know what, let me Okay, Okay, this was something I did before. Docs.springstack.dev. Yes, Gitbook. I was using Gitbook before. All right, imagine now this. I was using this because I was an on-coder and I created this amazing starter kit. And I used Gitbook for this. All right, so let's just look at Gitbook. Gitbook is basically that. Like you can create your own documentations and then you can just customize it a little bit and then just host it, I guess, right? So imagine, guys, this is basically a direct competitor to Gitbook. Anybody can now create their own Gitbook and then just host it by themselves, brand it as they wish, without even having that Gitbook logo in the sidebar. Like you can literally customize this as you wish. And again, as you can see, I'm not writing a single line of code. All I'm doing is prompting. That's just, natural language. All right, so I just added this. All right, so now let's read through what it says. I'll add a Slack integration page to the navigation and create the corresponding page with content you've provided. I'll expand on it slightly to fit our documentation style. That is perfect. All right, so these are the changes that I've made. All right, so documentation starter. All right, so this was it. It added it in this app sidebar, okay? And then there's a Slack integration. Okay, I don't know where, who cares, who gives a shit? Let's just look at it, all right, so perfect. Slack integration and introduction, our Slack integration enhances, all right? So just created shit out of thin air. But this doesn't look good, right? So what if we say, why don't you create like a snippet where the code is clearly defined in a more, snippet-like format? Let's just do that. In the entire documentation, not just Slack integration, right? In the entire documentation, why don't you make the code in proper snippet format? Like this could be much more better and visually pleasing for anyone reading the doc if it's in a terminal style snippet. Please make these changes. All right, I know a lot of spelling errors, a lot of typos, but who cares, right? Just keep typing and then it'll just do the work for you. All right, so let's see what it does. Okay, this page isn't available, but that's something if you want to build, we can build it. All right, so it's making another component called code snippet. So let's see how that looks like. The preview is still not available. Preview is disabled because, look at that. It's like, like a ghost coding for you, right? That's exactly how it looks like. Like a ghost coding for you. And that's fucking crazy, guys. Like, now anybody can code. I just don't understand, how. I know a lot of people say, okay, code isn't that great. A lot of developers, I just got a lot of hate in my previous video saying, you're a non-coder. You don't know anything. Because you'll have to spend 10 years in the software development industry. I honestly don't give a shit, because if you're able to build products and ship them and just make money out of it, add value to whatever you're building, whatever you're creating, if you're basically adding value to the world, it doesn't matter what tech you're using, if you're coding or not, it's just the end product that matters, and that's all. And that's perfect, guys, that is perfect. As you can see, it just made this copy button as well, but I don't think the copy button is functional. Maybe we'll have to make it functional. But yes, it just says Python, and I don't know if it's Python or not. It's not actually Python, right? Because the code is DSX and it just says Python here. But if you just want to keep iterating on this, we can. We can literally just keep iterating on this. But one simple suggestion that I'll give you guys is, Let's say if you're making these tiny adjustments for Python, just making it dynamic, saying, make this code snippet dynamic, you know, basically look into whatever code this is and make this thing dynamic. If it's JavaScript, it's going to say JS. If it's Python, it's going to say Python, HTML, HTML. I would suggest not to just do it in the same chat because v0 hallucinates really badly. I mean, it's like your drunk uncle on a Saturday evening. So it doesn't really understand what it's trying to do. And even the copy button. So these tiny elements, I'd suggest you'd either create a new fork. You basically create a new fork where it just creates a complete new fork. The entire block is being forked. Now this is there. Now you could go ahead and say, hey, I would like to make changes for this where you'd basically make this dynamic and functional. Or the best way to again do it is at the code base, download the zip file, or just copy this and just run this command in the terminal of your cursor. Or you just do it on cursor or windsurf. It's much better that way. And then, I mean, I'd say cursor and windsurf are really good for nuanced changes, nuanced coding, but they're really bad at giving a macro interface. So I think just to put it in words, v0 is good for macro and cursor and the other IDE is good for micro, right? So micro adjustments. I hope you guys get the point here and what I'm trying to say. But I think that's about it. That's exactly what I wanted to share with you guys. Maybe in other videos, I'll be sharing with you how you can deploy. You can directly deploy this to Vercel right now. You can just, add your chat to a project and to deploy, right? So simple. And you can actually add custom domains for this. That basically means you can just host it from here. But I don't think it's, that convenient because these kind of changes really take a lot of time on v0. You can just copy the code, take it on cursor, and then you can host it on GitHub and then Vercel, right? And then you can connect the domain easily. So that's something I'd suggest. But guys, as you can see, we just created something that we would have to pay to create. I mean, we would have to pay, okay, let's say we do monthly. All right, so it's free for something, but yeah, premium, get fully branded AI-powered documentation the users would love, right? I mean, let's say if you had to build this, you'd have to pay $79 a month to just, build the entire thing using Gitbook. But now I can just do this using Vercel for like $20 a month. That's basically the subscription price of Vercel, of v0, right? That's crazy, guys. I hope you guys get what I'm exactly trying to say because it just changes everything. I know I keep saying it just changes everything a lot of time, but it does change everything, right? I mean, it is getting crazy. I mean, if you know what you're doing, it's really good for you. And yeah, there's going to be a compound effect. If you're watching my videos, if you're learning from me, there's definitely going to be a compound effect, which will soon hit you, your career, and it's exponential gain, like super linear returns. So do follow me, do subscribe to my channel, and I'm actually starting my own newsletter as well. So newsletter, I'm going to use Beehive too, to my own newsletter, and then I'll start sending newsletters to you guys about AI, all the advancements that are happening, maybe even, share summary pointers of my videos as well. So let's do that. And also I'm getting sponsors and why wouldn't I want more sponsors, right? Because people are liking my videos. So I think 2025, I'm going to focus a lot more on YouTube. So yes, that's all guys. And as you can see again, me, autistic geek, that's all for us again, peace. I just love you guys, right? I mean, thank you for all the love that I've been getting on YouTube, and it's just been super fun, guys. Thanks again. Peace.